Hi guys, welcome to another market news and updates. I'm your host Omi. Welcome to Omi Miz YouTube channel. Today we're gonna find out whether BTC is gonna be remaining in 50,000s or there's a possibility of a downside back to 47 or 46. Let's find out in today's video. The first news we have today is Vitalik outlines endgame roadmap for Ethereum 2.0. The Ethereum 2 launch process began in November 2020. The network switch to proof of stake is expected to make Ethereum a deflationary asset. This is going to be amazing news and everybody's very excited that we're expecting Ethereum 2.0 to come. As we know, it's going to help people solve a lot of problems. Ethereum 2.0 isn't going to solve all of society's challenges, but its design is well suited to empower people to solve them together. Arches Victor Boonin. So this is going to be massive news. We're expecting this is going to be happening anytime soon. The outline for the roadmap shows us sometime in May or April, and that could be the extended bull rally results as well. The second news we have for us today is CME Group launches Micro Ether Futures as Ether hovers at 4K. Micro Ether Futures join crypto derivatives products including micro Bitcoin futures, Bitcoin futures options on Bitcoin futures and Ether futures at the exchange. The newest member of CME Group cryptocurrency product family has arrived. Micro Ether futures are available for trading. So now you can expect Ethereum to be trading on futures as well when it comes to especially CME Group. And this can be a very, very bullish sign for the market. But at the same time, we've learned and seeing in the futures that just now when we got ETF futures for Bitcoin, it increases the leverage so much that we don't expect a very big upside in the markets or per market dump hona shuru ho jati hai because logon ne bahut zyada loan aur udhar liya hua hota exchanges se. The last news we have today is from Asia. First move Asia, Bitcoin tops 50k, Ether other altcoins rise. Bitcoin trading volume was down for the second consecutive day. As we know, Bitcoin काफी sideways हुआ हुआ था and slowly Bitcoin has been gaining momentum. As I've seen early morning today, Bitcoin's dominance has also increased. Overall, अगर हम लोग Bitcoin की volume by exchanges देखें, so we're having a very hard time in having massive volume weeks. Volume is of market में बहुत कम है. The dump volumes are way bigger than the pump volumes, and this can be a cause of concern right now for us. And this could bring BTC back to different levels. Mainly all eyes were on Chinese stock market as Bitcoin funding rates on Chinese derivative exchange slowly recovered from negative territory. Bitcoin was stabilizing above its 20-day average 2 days after its 20% plump. So overall, if you look at the market is not really decided yet. It's still very undecided. The very concerned thing for us was that funding rate went negative. So that's all for our news. Let's see what's happening in our charts and technicals. देखते हैं फिर आज हमारा क्रिप्टो ग्रीड एंड फियर इंडेक्स में क्या हालात हैं. Either people very fearful or they have become greedy. And today we are still at 25, but it's good to see we pumped from 16 as expected. When things are in extreme fear, the market obviously is going to take some sort of a bounce from extreme fear. Some people like to take opportunities and this is what happens. Coin market cap mein agar hum log dekhen, and let's jump in right into seeing ye kaun se coins and they have been pumping a lot. So the first winner we have today is BitTorrent. Pumped 60% in the last 24 hours. We have Loopring LRC 35% up. We have Bitcoin SV 31% up. Polygon Matic just broke into 2.34. It's 32% up. KDA 30%. So there's a massive upside coming. 24% from FTM. Some coins have done very, very well because a lot of correction and pullback was happening, and some of them have broken free. Let's see which are the coins that couldn't do much and are still dumping or in a pullback. We have Waves, we have Terra USD, mostly stable coins. That gives us the feeling that the market has become very bullish right now in this short term. Charts mein dekhte hain. So in the charts we have Ethereum's dominance. Ethereum dominance is still in a very good upside and it's still in a strong uptrend from here. We started after bouncing from 20.61. We need Ethereum to be keep going up so we can go to similar levels of 2018 and 2017 May and April. Let's check out what's happening in Bitcoin's dominance as well. As we can see, Bitcoin's dominance is making a very nice cup and handle kind of situation right now, but not exactly a cup because our neckline is not same. So if we look at it, it's still in a very strong downtrend and it's been going down, though it might just make a W shape here. If it does, there's a high possibility that it should rise. We want BTC's dominance to go back to 42, 43, 44, 45. 44, 45 would be the most ideal situation for it to rally upside and make some big moves. If we look at others' dominance right now, others' dominance came down, but it has taken support and bounced from 15.45, which shows us that altcoins can have some sort of a cushion and some comfort zone right now in the markets. If you look at BTC's chart, BTC right now is still in my weekly chart in a very strong downtrend, and we are getting some rejection from 51,000 at the moment. We're trying to retest and possibly maybe make an entry to here, but the next targets are 53 and 55. Things are looking very, very interesting right now. Let's see what's happening in our Ethereum's chart as well. Agar hum Ethereum ko dekhen, to Ethereum has come back into our weekly trend line and it's now building support around 4,400. If we understand the reason why all this is happening on Ethereum is rallying alone without Bitcoin, we just understood from the news that there's so much bullish news about ETH 2.0 and also ETH futures by CME groups. AXS ko dekhen, to AXS is also doing pretty well. It's in our support zone and taking a small nice pump from there. Overall, if you look at the market, everything is doing pretty well. Solana is back in $200 and is also taking a similar pump as AXS was doing. If you look at EGLD, to EGLD bhi similar situation mein hai, is taking a nice pump from its support zones, and mainly all the coins right now are in a strong pump and they are building support from the last dump we had. The only thing concerning right now is I hope that we don't see lower highs and we dump further down, and from here we're able to change trend. If we look at Mana's price, Mana right now is trading above $4. Good to see for it to come back from our dump of 2.3 back to $4. That is a very good turnaround in a few hours. If we look at Stacks. Stacks is doing pretty well. Stacks right now is at $2.04. Overall, if we look at the market is all right, but we have to be very careful and monitor Ethereum's dominance and BTC's dominance as well. Let's have a final say on BTC, and I feel like that there's a high possibility that we might have a situation like this where we might get rejected, or we can have a situation where we can break upside. So let's see what's gonna be happening in the market, and we're gonna be updating you tomorrow again. So that's all for today's video, guys. I hope you liked the video. Smash the like button, share your thoughts in the comment section. We're gonna be having a lot of giveaways on our Twitter and YouTube channel. Stay tuned, subscribe, and take care, guys. Bye bye.